Good morning, students. Once again, you are most welcome in our mathematics class. Today we are going to start our fifth chapter. The name of the chapter is fraction. Before starting the chapter, we have to know what is the mean of fractions. So, how can come to know what is the mean of fractions? Before that, whenever we have the things and we want to count their things, so how you are counting that? We are using the counting numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that way. If I said how many markers I have at present, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I deduct 1 from it, so now 1, 2, 3. Again deduct 1 from it, so it will become 1, 2. Again deduct 1, so it will become 1. And if I break this marker or cut this marker within the two parts, at that time how many markers should I have? How we can represent that? As because that one marker should be divided into two parts, so at that time how we are going to say that? Means at that time we are using the fractions. So what is the fraction? We can say a fraction is a part of whole. If we have any whole numbers, any whole things, and we are taking a specific part of that, so that we are going to represent by a fraction. So let's see what is the fraction. Fraction. A fraction represents a part of whole. Means if we have the any things, a whole things, and we are taking a small part of that, or any other quantity, a part of that, that is called a fraction. Now one more thing regarding the fraction. A fraction describes how many parts of a certain size there are. For example, 1/2. Means if we have any part of that whole. So how we are going to say? If you are divided into within the two equal parts, so we can say that is 1/2 of that. 1/2, the total is 1 and we divide it into two parts, means that is the half, so we can say 1/2. So let's see, you can see here we have a diagram of an apple. So if you want to say how many apple is this, this is the one apple. Now that is divided into the two parts, so how we are going to count these two part of the apple? So, as because I'm talking about this first part, so this is the one, out of these two, one, two, so it will become the down. Got it? Means here I'm talking about this one, this first one is the first part out of the whole, that is two. How many parts we have? How many pieces we have? We have the two pieces of apple. So we are talking about this first piece. So one, that is one piece upon out of this two. It will become 1/2. So we can denote 1/2 the same way. Now, let's think about this second one. It is also a part, a piece of apple. And it is also considered out of these two. Means the whole is two. So we can say it is also 1/2. So whenever we have an apple and we divide it within the two parts, so it will consider like 1/2, means half. In our general language, we are saying that that is the half. Yes, half of an apple. Let's see another example. Here we have a strip and that is divided within a four equal parts. Let's think, I'm talking about this shaded part, that is one. Out of how many we have? We have the total 1, 2, 3, 4. Total how many parts we have? 4. So that will become the down. Yes, so 1/4. If we can say this 2, 1, 2, means we are talking about the two parts out of the four. Yes, that will become 2/4. If we consider one more within this shaded part, it will become 1, 2, 3. It will become 3. Out of total is again 4. 1 upon 4 if we have the one shaded part. If we have the 2, 2 upon 4. If we have the 3, 3 upon 4. If we have all the shaded part, means 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 4 and total is 4. Let's do we are able to do the cancellations? 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, it will become 1 upon 2. Anywhere else, 4 1s are 4, 4 1s are 4, it will become 1. So, if we have 1 upon 4, if we have 1 upon 4, that is called a quarter. If we have 1 upon 2, that is half. If we have 3 upon 4, that is 3 quarter. And if we have 1, that is the, we can say, whole or 1. So this way we are going to read this 1 upon 4, 1 upon 2, 3 upon 4, and 4 upon 4 means 1. And the most important things, whenever we are talking about this fraction, suppose here we are talking about this 1 upon 2. So in this 1 upon 2, what should we have? At the top we have 1 and at the bottom we have 2. So the number which we have at the top, that is called numerator. That is called numerator. And the digit, the number which is at the bottom, at the place of bottom, that is called denominator. That is called denominator. And if we are going to consider these two along with together, that is nothing else, that is called fraction. That is called fraction, means whenever we are talking about this 1 upon 2, we are talking about a first piece, a piece of the whole of two parts. Now, let's see in detail what is numerator and denominator. Whenever we are talking about the numerator, so what is it? The top digit that represent the part of the whole. The top digit that represent the part of the whole, that is called numerator. Let's see in our example, if I am talking about this one part, the first piece, that is a part of the whole. The total we have 2. Out of that we are talking about this first piece. So that is the 1. Out of these 2, we are talking about this 1, that is called numerator. Let's see the denominator. What is denominator? The bottom digit that represent the whole. See in your example, here we have the two pieces of an apple. Means the whole, what is the whole? We have total, whole means total. Whole, the two pieces we have. And that is in the bottom, that digit 2. So this is called denominator. So this way, whenever we have any of the number that less than 1, we want to count it. That is called in a fraction, a part of whole. That we learn. The digit that is at the top and representing that part of that whole, that is called numerator. And the digit at the bottom that represent the whole, that is called denominator. The next concept in the same fractions is equivalent fraction. What is an equivalent fraction? Fractions having equal values. Fractions having equal values are called equivalent fractions. Means whenever we have the two fractions and the value of these two fractions will be the same, that time we can say that are the equal fractions. Let's see for an example. If we have the first one, 1 upon 2, the first fraction, and the second fraction is 2 upon 4, can we say these two fractions are the equivalent fraction? Yes, let's decide it. The first one, as it is, we can able to reduce it 1 upon 2. Second one, 2 upon 4. If you are able to see 2 upon 4, 2 and 4 both are the multiple of 2. So can we divide these 2 by 2? Always, if you want to do any of the mathematical operation, so we have to do with in the both numerator as well as denominator. So let's do divide it. Numerator as well as denominator by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. Now you can see the first we have 1 upon 2 and the second we got the value of 2 upon 4 is reduced from 1 upon 2. Can we say these two are the same? Yes, these two are the same. Means these two, 1 upon 2 as well as 2 upon 4 are the equivalent fractions. So we can say 1 upon 2 and 2 upon 4 are an equivalent fractions. So this way we can check it. We can go into identify whether the given fractions are equivalent fractions or not. So on the basis of this concept of the fractions, we have our next problem set number 17. In that also we have the fractions and we are going to follow all the rules of these fractions, numerator, denominator, equivalent fractions, and the one most important things what we learn. If you want to do any of the mathematical operations within the fractions, we have to do in the both numerator as well as denominator. If we are multiplying the numerator by any number, so the same time in the same fraction we are going to multiply the denominator also by the same number. If you are dividing the numerator by any number, so we have to divide the denominator also by the same number. That is the most important things we have to recall, that we have to keep in our mind whenever we are solving the sum of the fractions. So let's see problem set number 17. Here we have the question number 1. Write the proper number in the box. You are able to see here we have the boxes like the fill in the blanks. And we have to put the proper numbers. What will going to come in that box? So let's start. Here 2. This 2 become 20. Just think regarding it. If a smaller number become greater than itself, means something should be multiplied in that, means that we don't know and we are getting the answer 20. So what should we have to multiply in this 2 will get the answer 20? 10. 2 tens are 20. Therefore means 2 tens are 20. In the denominator there's 2 multiplied by 10, so we got the answer 20. And what I said, whenever we are doing the any of the mathematical operations like multiplying and divisions, the same thing we have to do in the both numerator as well as denominator. So the same thing, the same number should be multiplied in the denominator also. So it will become 1 into 10, and in the denominator we already have multiplied by 10, it will become 20, and numerator will become 10. So here a number come 10. Come for the second one. Here you can see 3 multiplied by which number, so we will get the 15? 3 5s are 15. If 3 multiplied by 5, the same time we have to multiply this 4 also by 5. So therefore 3 upon 4, numerator as well as denominator both multiply by 5, will get 15 upon 20. So here the number comes 20. In the next one, here 9 multiplied by which number we got the 18? 2. 9 2s are 18. So therefore 9 upon 11 both are multiplied by 2 will get 18 upon 22. So which number should come over here? 22. Come for the fourth one. Here 40 become 8. Just think, in the earlier sums and in this fourth sum, what is the difference between these two? In the previous sums, we have the smaller number and we are getting the bigger than that itself. Means So at that time we are multiplying in each and every sums. But here if you remember, if you are able to see, 40 becomes 8. Whenever we are getting the less number by itself, that means there we are going to divide it. So by which number we are going to divide the 40 to get the 8 answer? There is nothing to worry, just divide it, 40 by 8 will get the answer. 8 5s are 40, means this 40 is divided by 5, so we got the answer 8. Therefore 10 upon 40, both numerator as denominator divided by 5, we got the value 5 2s are 10, 5 8s are 40. So the number should come over here, 8. Come for the next one. Here also we have one more. Here this 26 become 13. 13 2s are 26, means this 26 should be divided by 2. Therefore 14 upon 26, both numerator as well denominator divided by 2, we got 7 upon 13. 13 we already have, put 7 over here. The same way, the remaining question number 6, 7 and 8, you should be do by your own self. That is the homework for you. So this way we learn about the fractions and the sums based on the fractions. So you have to solve these 3 sums in your homework and you should be submitting your group on Friday. And if you have still any kinds of the doubt regarding these sums, you should ask in group. The next question number 2, we will continue in the next video. Thank you so much.